Today, friends, I'm going to show you how to use the brand new Tinkercad sketch tool to make an awesome 3D printable waving flag. So let's get cracking. Friends, a user asked how to make the Puerto Rican flag and have it easily print in multicolor. I've got a strategy. Let me show you what we did. First thing I did was find the flag, and then I used a screen capture tool to grab an image of it. My screen capture tool is Snagit. I absolutely love it and highly recommend it. And now we need a bounce to pick SVG. Once you arrive at pick SVG, simply upload your picture. Of course, mine is in my screenshots folder. I can grab it and choose open. When it arrives, I do not want this one with the edges. Instead, I like to use the internal one, and I often picked internal two. Do notice it took these colors and combined it to one. I'm going to show you how that works with the brand new sketch tool in Tinkercad. I'm going to save it to my downloads folder, keep the goofy name. Of course, now we can bounce to Tinkercad. That's going to be our finished result. Let me show you how we get there. Step one is going to be to name it, and I'm going to put flag after it. Once again, this was a user request. You can do this with any flag that you want. I'm going to start by choosing import, and I'm going to grab that file from my downloads folder. When I bring it in, I do want to choose art, and then I want to make this less than the 200 that the work plane is. So I'm going to type 180 and press enter. After a moment, bingo, there is our flag shape. Now, of course, we need three colors. We need blue, we need red, and then inside we need white. Let me show you how we're going to do this using the brand new sketch tool. Once we enter, we can zoom out, and I'm going to choose to make the blue triangle first. Now I'm going to shut off my snap grid so that way I can get right to these corners. And I'm going to simply click down here on this corner. Let's zoom in and get as close as we can. I think that's going to be perfect. Now I'm going to zoom out, and I'm going to push my scroll wheel in so that I can pan. And I'm going to come down here and find this corner. Once again, because I shut off that grid, we can get as close as we want. Then I'm going to zoom back out, once again push in the scroll wheel to pan, and then we need to make the triangle of the flag. Now it does come out here to the middle. I can't see where the exact middle is. If you look closely at this piece, it is not centered on our work plane. So I'm going to just come close, and then I'm going to connect. And now we can use our modification tools to grab and get it to the exact center. You'll know you have it right when these lines match up on both sides. You can spend a lot of time getting these perfect. I'm gonna just get it close for this project. All right, so that is gonna be the triangle piece. When we hit finish sketch, I can now take this and make it taller, switch it to a hole. I'm gonna do Control D and make the new one dark blue, and I'm going to lock it. Now I'm gonna click on the hole. And with that hole selected, I'm going to do D to drop. I can now shift select the hole, shift select the rest of the flag. And when we do Control G to group, notice it says node fails to load. I'm going to just click and ungroup it. And I'm going to do that step again. Once again, shift select Control G to group. And after a moment, that one snaps just like it's supposed to. Now notice we did not quite get to this line right here. So I'm gonna just double click. I'm gonna click on my hole, and I am gonna stretch it out the tiniest little bit. What that meant was that line on that edge wasn't straight, but as you can see, when I click and set it down, now that is perfect. I'm gonna click on this one, unlock it, and let's do D to drop. Let's check the height of our original project, and we can match these up 10 and 10 and press enter. These are going to be the red parts. Let's make them look red real quick. Maybe find a red that's a little closer to the real red. Of course, you can be as perfect with that as you want. And now let me show you how to get this other part. Once again, we're going to go to sketch. I'm going to zoom out. I still have the snap grid off. I'm going to get in on this corner right here. Click and click. Once again, these are nice straight lines, and click to connect. I can grab this and move it out to the exact spot. adjust these as much as you want until you're happy. As you can see, our SVG is not perfect, so it'd probably be smart to redraw those parts as well. Of course, I don't need this, so I'm just going to stop with it as close as I can get. I am going to call that good and hit finish. Of course, that one needs to be white. We're going to hit D to drop so it's in place. And then we're going to make a second one down here. We're going to turn our nudge back on. Let's go with 1. Control D, shift nudge. And then I want to line it up right with this spot. So I'm going to hit W for work plane, D to drop. And then we're going to use the mirror tool to flip it. Bingo. You've got your flag parts added. W for work plane to set it on the bottom. The last thing we need is a star. Tinkercad gives us a star. I'm going to set it to white. And I'm going to rotate it so that it's the right angle. Notice if you go 20 degrees, that stands it straight up. If I select these two and do L for align, I do want it centered that way. And we could find the exact spot that way by using guess and check. Now, to make this work on a multicolor printer, I have found it's better to keep the pieces separate. So we've got a blue piece, we've got the red, and then we'll have the white pieces. Before we do the white pieces, I don't want these to intersect. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do Control D, lock the white one, and hide the white one. Now I can click on the other one that was there and make it a hole, D to drop, and take the blue and the star and do Control G to group. Show all brings back our white star, ungroup, and of course we need to set the height to 10 and press enter. D to drop, and bam, you have just made your Puerto Rican flag. I can quickly double click on our sketch, and if I click over here on this line, I can match those up. If I grab the point, it lets me stretch it to the exact spot I want to be at. Once again, notice it wasn't going where I want. That's because I've got to shut off the grid to get those so they line up. Once again, I'm making this for fun. If you're trying to make one that you're really, really worried about being perfect, you may want to draw this outside edge with the straight lines as well, just so everything lines up perfectly. I'm going to hit finish sketch. Those are now lined up better. And let me show you how to make it into a waving flag. The first thing we're going to do is grab everything and change the height to 30 or 40. I'll make it 40 just because that works out pretty well. Like, look at it from the front. Bring out your sketch tool. And we're going to put 4 humps on this using the sweet Bezier curves. Click out here near the middle. Click and hold. And once again, it's going to be 4 humps. So there's hump 1, hump 2. Notice I can just click to match that curve. Hump 3, I got to click and hold. And hump 4, click to finish. I want to switch to a straight line and just come out, up, over, and back so we can create our cutting block. When we're done, we can hit finish sketch. Once again, turn that into a cutting block. I'm going to switch my nudge to 5 just because this makes it a little faster. Do Control up so that's a little higher. And I'm going to do Control D and D to drop. And then I'm going to use Control down to move it underneath. And then using the mirror tool, we're simply going to flip this. Of course, we want the top to be up. And we want to flip the curves so they match. Check it out. There is your waving flag. If I do Control up a couple times, we can get it to the right height. Now we need to take this block and we need to stretch it out so it cuts everything. Now, to print multicolor, it is more slick if you've got separate pieces. Let me show you how we're going to make that happen. I'm going to select the entire cutting block. I'm going to do Control D. And then I'm going to shift nudge it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 out of the way. Now I can click the red, shift click the 2 cutting blocks. Notice it says 3 shapes and do Control G to group. So we have just cut all the red sections. I'm going to click on those. Notice they accidentally moved, so I'm going to do Control Z, and I'm going to lock them. So now the red pieces are finished. I'm going to select these and do Control D. Remember that shift nudge, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, to get it lined up. This time I'm going to grab the blue in the bottom. Notice that rectangle touches just the two shapes. Shift select to grab the top shape, and I'm going to do Control G to group. Those parts are cut. I can click on this one now and I can lock it as well. And then we can bring the rest over. Once again, shift nudge, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That all works because of this 5mm nudge. And now because everything's locked, I can simply grab everything, which even though it says 7 shapes, it's really just the white parts and the holes. And when I group them, you've just created a 3-color waving flag. How cool is that? I am going to unlock everything. So if I lock and unlock, they're ready for 3D printing. Now, friends, I have no need to print a large flag. This was requested by another user. Just let me show you the steps if you were sending it to a Bambu Labs printer. I would select simply the red shape. I would do export, STL, and I would change this to PR flag red and save it. Of course, I would also do the blue. Once again, STL, and label this one with blue. And then, of course, I would also select the white, export selected shape, and label it white. Real quickly, let me show you how the steps look in Bambu Lab Studio. Of course, begin by creating a brand new project. I'm going to bring in all three pieces at once. That way they stay aligned. Yes, it is a single object, multiple parts. If we switch over to our object menu, of all the lucky things, I actually had red, white, and blue in the printer. So I'm going to simply select the white selection and make it white. I'm going to select the blue, it already is blue, and select the red and make it red. If we go back to global, I would have to enable supports because of it being wavy. And if we hit slice plate, at this size, it would take 12 hours and 58 minutes. You can see it would be switching colors underneath there, which does take extra time. Just for giggles, let's see what it'd look like if we did it vertically. When we use rotate to stand it up, that would remove the need for supports. Let's quickly hit slice plate. And after a moment, are you ready for this? We're looking at a 30-hour print. Let's undo all that real quickly, just so we can go back to the early orientation. Once again, slice plate, and bingo, you're looking at a fun flag in about 13 hours. Friends, there you have it, another fun, fast way that you can put the Tinkercad sketch tool to use. Friends, I do also want to say thanks to my supporters on Patreon. Absolutely love how that group is growing. Of course, you can learn more by checking the link in the description or the bit.ly up above. Finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget, every time you hit that like button, share a video, add a comment down below, or hit subscribe. You're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day, and keep tinkering.